everybody, this is Jeffrey again, and we're here for our next exercises. So these drills from this manual are super important, and if you are watching this on YouTube, I'll have a link to the manual in the description below. So we're here with Better West Coast Swing, and if you notice something with my feet, my shoes are tied together. Now, guys, this is what I'm going to recommend the men do. I don't necessarily recommend it for the girls, but you need to realize how big or how small, I should say, your steps really need to be. Now, guys, so tie your shoes together so they're no wider than the width of your shoulders, okay? So that's important to understand, because when you start off dancing, you're going to find that when you're doing your steps, your basic steps, you're going to step too big. Now, this allows me to step pretty decent size. This is a lot more than I actually need. So you'll notice that my steps will be actually much smaller. So I want to have a little bit of slack in there, so in case I make a mistake, but I don't want to fall, of course. So that'd be funny. So the idea is we're going to tie your shoes together and we're going to work on your basics. So I'm going to do the men's part and then we'll talk about the women's part. So guys, so always standing here with your properly, with your sit bone back over your heel, your head weight back over your shoulders, and so your head weight's over the ball of feet. So when we lift our sit bone, okay, that lifts your pelvic floor. Now guys, as you start to move your body, you'll notice that as we move our body, that I want you to take your hand and I want you to place it on the middle of your back. And I want to feel that I move my center and my head back into my hand. So just feel it move back into your hand. So once you feel that body move into your hand, you feel it, you can see it when I'm doing it. Or you can have your partner help you, you can put their hand in the back and have them feel it and tell you. But I want you to feel that. And then see as my sit bone starts to move past my heel, look at my left knee. My left knee goes forward. And so now my body is going to tell me where to place my foot. Look at my sit bone and my foot. It tells me where to place it, all right? If I were just to step and not do my body and just step, I'm going to step way too big. Look how tight your laces are at this point. So I want to feel that my feet stay very close together. And we're going 3 and 4. Now, guys, we're a little bit bigger on the 4 on the sugar push, because we want to come back to where we started. That might be a little bit challenging with the shoes tied, but just understand that you're not just going step, step, blah, 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 all right? So we're going to use our center weight to move us and then tell our body where our feet should step. And here, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, and then. Now, guys, real important that you understand on the 6 of the anchor, you should not have your heel down. You don't want to go quick, slow, or 1, 2, 3, whatever, and stomp your feet. You're not stomping grapes. So you want to feel that your heel, the way I do it, is your heel does not lower until after you've passed your foot. Now, my teachers have always get me to move on the 5. So guys, we'll do a video on that a little bit more with a partner. But as I'm going 5 and 6 and, so my foot weight, this heel will not lower until I go by. So I'm going to go 5 and 6 and, okay? Because I want to feel 5 and 6 and a 1 is my beat. But my heel didn't lower until I got past it. So that's important that you practice that and understand the control that it takes through your foot, okay? And lifting your pelvic floor to be sure you're not slamming your heels so far and falling back. So let's just do our passes and pushes real quick. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, and 4. Final pass, underarm turn. 1, 2, same crossing over. 3 and, whoa. See, too big, right? So it's 1, 2, 3, it's a caught underneath my heel. 4, so just be careful when you do this, right? And then a whip, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So just be careful. And you don't really need to tie your shoes together. It's just to show you that how small my steps really are. So just be careful because it can caught underneath your heel. Now, when I was competing, the very first time I ever competed, I said to myself in my head over and over, your shoes are tied, your shoes are tied, your shoes are tied, your shoes are tied, all the entire stupid song, because I didn't want to take too big of steps. And I practiced every day like this just until I started realizing that my steps were getting smaller and smaller when I didn't have them tied. So I would suggest you practice, whether you use shoelaces or you just pay attention to where your feet are. Either way works. girls, it is the same thing for you. You have to understand that your steps are not as big as you think they are. There is, you're going 1, 2. Okay, you want to know that where your partner is and understand how to dance to the zone. And we'll talk more about that when we have a partner. But understand, keep your steps small, especially your three. Just focus on this and start moving your body. And you can practice, do simple practice exercises by keeping your feet together and just move your body. Just move, and then as you move your body, move it far enough where you have to step. That's the easiest way to start practicing with your body. So, I hope this helps and that it makes sense, and it's a good thing I didn't fall with my shoelaces tied. I thought it'd be funny. But anyways, guys, everybody, have a great day. Work on this stuff and be a good human.